this, what do you got?
We're live.
Okay.
Looking good.
Sounds good, thank you.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I see you got so much. So I'll call the tunes for you. How's that sound? Hey everybody, welcome to the world famous Silver Lining Livestream. I've added the term world famous to this because I am just hoping that that makes it world famous by my saying so. It works for everyone else, why don't I do it? So the world famous Silver Lining Livestream, the great John Moak on trombone, and I am of course
the world famous Christopher Woitach.
Right, world famous Christopher Woitach. I forgot my name for a minute.
Our world has gotten very small.
So. Yes, very, very small. This is our world. Tonight is 70s night. And for us who came of age in the 70s, it's overwhelming to choose 70s music. So we have a mix of things. This is by no means representative. This is just the first batch. If we continue doing this, which I plan to till we don't anymore, however long that is, if we continue doing this, there will be more 70s nights that are a little more on point, but this is a very wide swath of 70s, and we have a very special birthday tonight too. And as you know, the birthday shenanigans have become crazy, and this is one of the crazier ones. So I guess I just turned on my guitar, huh?
Cheater.
All right. So we're going to start with one of my personal favorite bands. Amazingly good band, in fact. The Jackson 5. Yeah.
Thank you.
Both of us have decked ourselves out in the closest we can get. Anything that, so long as it doesn't look like disco, because disco sucks. Just saying. Disco sucks. That's all there is to it. I was raised in the 70s. I know disco sucks. Okay. However, what doesn't suck at all is one of the most soulful brother and sister situations we've ever heard. And yet, I think we agreed that it's like soulful without any sex. Mm-hmm. And that's okay. That's fine. It's beautiful, beautiful and sad story and all that. But this is a song called Superstar. And no, not from Jesus Christ Superstar, but Superstar by the Carpenters.
Music by Leon Russell.
Oh, yeah. Leon Russell wrote that. It's funny. I didn't even notice that. Wow. Okay. There will be... It's difficult. There's certain performers who it is going to be very difficult to not give their own night to. And Leon Russell's one of them. We'll find a way to mix him up with someone else that we like. Jimmy Webb or I don't know, something.
No. Someone. Two nights.
Yeah, that's two nights. Okay, so, better give me the count here because I'll get it wrong. Carpenters, very hip, in my opinion. You know, one thing I made a note of for myself, somewhere. Oh yeah, here we go. So in the 70s, I learned a few life lessons that have absolutely zero application to today's world. And I thought I would share them with you. Let's see. One was, if the teacher didn't actually see you with a cigarette in your hand, they couldn't suspend you. Even if the bathroom was cloudy with smoke. So that's useful. What was another one I came up with? There was a couple of good ones. Oh, yeah. Double albums. Double albums, I am convinced, were invented for the sole purpose of cleaning the seeds and stems out of your Colombian marijuana. And they really made it easier. If you tried to smoke that without cleaning it first, you would, first of all, it tastes like crap, and second of all, you'd get seed burns on your shirts, which all my shirts had. So the 70s was an interesting time. And that brings me around to, I don't know why, to an important thing. Tonight is the night before the birthday, so tomorrow is his birthday, of one of the most important people in my life, and that's my big brother. I'm going to start by saying, Steve, you know, I think you're listening. I'm sorry, man. I'm just really sorry. But I was young. I was a kid. I was a 13-year-old kid. And so, yeah, I did look in your drawers. And, yeah, okay, so I stole a couple joints from you, all right? I'm sorry. Just please. I'll get them back for you somehow. I don't know how. I learned from there one of the great mysteries of my life, which was, what does it mean when there's two soda cans taped together and there's water in them, little droplets of water? Well, it turns out, of course, that's a bong, but I didn't know that at the time. The music, two of the, you know, so what formed me in the 70s, and I, you know, I'm sure you don't care, but I'm here and you're there, so ha-ha, were the three things, the three big things, sex, drugs, and rock and roll. That's what happened to me in the 70s. Steve had absolutely nothing to do with the first one, but we've already discussed the second one, but the music, you know, from looking at his albums and listening to them and then exploring that stuff on my own, made me who I am. And through the years, Steve would get it upon himself to give me at Christmas time or whenever an album. And after I learned to play guitar, he'd give me these albums and say, hey, can you play that? And I couldn't. And I would go through and learn how to play all the stuff. I did that with a Jorma Kaukonen record called Qua. And David Grisman. That's kind of how I got into jazz. Even though my dad was a jazz player, I didn't think about it until I heard that music. And it kind of woke the part of me that had been listening to jazz since I was a baby. So anyway, we're going to wish him happy birthday, and please join in, because what do you think? F or C? What do you want?
C.
C.
Thank you.
birthday, Steve. Happy birthday. I'll be looking forward to, weather permitting, seeing you on Saturday. Did you notice the big man solo in there? Yeah, okay, it's a trombone, but so what?
People have been saying for dozens of years.
Yes, right.
It's a trombone, but so what?
It's a trombone, but so what? One of the things that happened in the 70s was I started performing a little bit. I mean, you know, that was when my performance world started. And this is kind of a personal joke, sort of from the sublime to the ridiculous here. This is a song that was hated by absolutely every single person who ever performed in the history of the world, right? Safe to say?
Absolutely.
The absolute worst, just most hated song, and that's why we're going to play it. A little different than, you know, than the normal way. But...
Thank you.
Some of you, who have no idea what that was, and I'm going to tell you right now, that's a song called Feelings, and if you want to kind of hear why everyone hates it, go ahead and look it up on YouTube. You'll enjoy the moment. So now, back from the ridiculous to the sublime, you know, I'm gonna be honest and say that at least half of the 70s I spent ripped, blasted, stoned all the time. And you know, I mean, I don't do that anymore, and that's great. But you know, that's what I did in the 70s. In fact, I had a and. You, my little sister, know about this. I had a high C can, and I took the... See, John, I'm gonna back up for a minute, because this matters. This actually matters to me. John and I started off the same. My first instrument was in band. I played tuba. And was yours trumpet?
No, I wanted to play alto saxophone. The band director lied to me and said my teeth were wrong and I had to play the trombone and the baritone horn.
Okay, so we started off in the lower brass together.
Yeah.
By eighth grade, that's seventh grade for me, and then by eighth grade I'd learned that the mouthpiece could hold about a quarter ounce of marijuana. And I stuck it in a high C can, and we had a little rubber hose, and sit around my mom's table in the hours between school and when she'd come home from work and just get blasted. Anyway, so if you've ever seen that 70s show where they're sitting around the table and they're like, whoa, man, you know, that's really how I sounded. And so I don't know why I found this amusing, but we decided to add a song from 1967 because that's like a very 70s thing to do. Yeah, man, like, let's add a song from 1967. It'd be like so 70s. Anyway.
I thought it'd be like if you're in the 80s and you thought you were still in the 70s.
Yeah, right. Well, there's that. You know. So this is one of the most beautiful songs ever written, and it is possibly the most incomprehensible song ever written. They must have just written down random words and stuck them together like David Bowie used to do, you know, or something. But it doesn't matter. The song's gorgeous. A whiter shade of pale. Thank you. That it dripped over a few years into the 70s. So. All right, well, that time... By the way, what time is it?
Excuse me.
Sure.
See, 5:47.
Yeah, perfection. We're going to play one more tune, and it really should have been Smoking in the Boys' Room. I was suspended quite a few times from high school for smoking in the boys' room and other things. And but we're not doing that. We're doing a different song. I hope you enjoyed yourself, Steve. I hope you had, you know, everything's great. Tomorrow, my brother and sister are going to take a birthday walk and a hike. Not a walk, a hike. And hopefully I'll see you soon.
Thank you. Thank you.
Have a wonderful evening.
Make sure you vote.
That's right. Hey, don't forget to vote. Vote. I don't care who you vote for.
Me.
Vote for me. Yeah, me too. John Moak.
Christopher Woitach.
And we'll be back next week with the Lord knows what. So anyway, have a great birthday, my big brother. Enjoy yourself. And my little sister, you enjoy him too.